Some of you might be familiar with the inscriptions Allah Dey and Olorunwa, which are popular inscriptions on the body of public transportations in Nigeria, like the downfalls, the Keke Napep, and trucks. Now, what if I tell you that there's a story behind these names? A sad and gruesome story. A story that took place in Ondo State in the early 1960s. In this story, we have Segun Wugirin, who is called Olorunwa. He was from Benin. We have Buraimo Otokiti, called Alade, from Sabo Gidon Ora, which is now part of Edo State, and Fumilayo, a pregnant woman from Ondo State. Now, in 1961, Olorunwa enrolled at Okelisa's Ansaruddin Modern School, but dropped out to start a white garment church, of which he was the pastor. He was a young boy whose heads eventually grew into dreadlocks, which is called Dada in Nigeria, which he said was a divine commandment. He became wealthy overnight, purchasing a Morris Minor taxi cab as his congregation increased. He had more females than males in his congregation. This is already a red flag. At this point, an apprentice carpenter named Alade joined Olorunwa's church, supposedly for evangelism. But was it? Nope, it wasn't. In actuality, it was for malicious purposes. As his church increased tremendously, pregnant women started disappearing little by little. The two of them specialized in bringing pregnant women to a river near the current location of Adeyemi College of Education under the guise of praying for safe delivery, where they would afterwards slaughter and dismember them to force out the fetuses for ritual purposes. They did this for so long and so smartly that they didn't arouse the suspicion of anyone. They were indeed intelligent ritualists. On this particular day, they took a pregnant woman named Fumilayo to the river for the supposed cleansing for safe delivery. At this point, they brought out their murdering tools and started slaughtering her. But Fumilayo was a strong woman, and despite the bandage over her mouth, she cried out and alerted the attention of a neighboring hunter who witnessed the horrific scene and whose evidence was used by the prosecution team to nail the bogus pastors. The indictment and subsequent conviction of these two individuals were considered one of the most famous murder trials in Ondo in the early 1960s. In 1963, Olorunwa and Allah Dey were tried and sentenced to death, and they were duly executed according to the law. The story of the duo's trial captivated the people of Ondo State, who had never previously encountered such barbaric acts on their soil. Like, they've never encountered such before in Ondo State. So these two were, I think they were in one of the foremost cases of ritualism in Yoruba land as a whole. So this is the story, and this is the end of the story of Allah Dey and Olorunwa. So when next you see these names, these inscriptions on vehicle, just remember this story. Bye-bye.